Chuck Woods. This is 3DS Max 2016 game has come out already. This is Max Design from Autodesk. 3D animation tool. Yeah. I got this model in here. It's a SketchUp model and it's highly detailed. The guy put his work in this one. And so I want to get it animated. Take it out for a spin. Right now I need to separate some of the geometry. This top propeller and its rear. I have the this propeller done. I need to do this rear propeller here, and they have to spin, right? I had converted the vehicle into a well, anyway, it's ready. Just gotta attach these pieces to it. Control Z, what the fuck is that? Right. Attach the wrong piece. So you have to get this hooked up. The modeler, the artist did a great job on this. And my job would be to get it animated. I'm having a problem. Need all these pieces animated. Control Z that. I don't want you then. Need this to spin. Oh, well, I didn't do the conversion here, so let me convert to an editable Holly. Is an animal body. What the hell am I doing? Yeah. See, it wasn't. Now I know what I'm doing. Right. That's what I need right there. I don't want any artifacts floating around. With that done, I want to check its pivot. Center that pivot. Alright. Till you get there. Yeah, the 3D artist put his work in on this one. So, I got that propeller separated. Had a little problem. I had to convert it to a editable poly. Then I can attach it, and its pivot point is centered. Well, if you want anything to rotate, you want your cancel that. You want your pivot points to be centered. You have to, if you want things to rotate, it's nice to have a center pivot point like with this one here. My pivot's out here. You want to redo that. In fact, pivot point is center object. All the pieces, well, you know, you can move it to about there. So I'll grab this one then. Move my pivot point there. It's pretty much centered, I guess. Right there. How about that? And a little closer. How about that? And really, I'll need to raise it. It's in there. Step out of that. And everything else is attached to this right here. Well, everything's in the box, right? So I close it, close the grouping. Yeah, everything's in there. And I want to unhide a piece. My rigging system. I have it set to be operated with the keyboard here, you know, forward, backwards, left, right, up, down, yaw. That's when the system do their stuff, you know, yawing. Even have the brake thing on it, the key J. You can change these keys. This is CraftDirector Studio, a plugin for 3ds Max, Maya, Cinema 4D, Soft Image, and a whole bunch of others. Rigging systems. You can get multiple vehicles in here, forklifts, trucks, bipedal creatures, bipedal two-legged people, right? I'm gonna close this, right? Close this and reveal it. Click this little thing right here, and it reveals it. And have it, some animation on it, just a rotation. I recorded that earlier. And now, to get the propellers in the right place, you wanna grab the, this is how I do it. You want to align this to the piece, the rear propeller here. Hit our alignment tool. Align to that, center, 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 center. Got it. And then parent link, our high poly to the low poly. Yeah, you want to do that. Parent linking is crucial. And I want to do the same with the top. I want to center this to our high poly. Then connect. Pivot is off again. Before I do that parent linking, I want to center this as best I can. Some piece of geometry is not in place. See if I got it centered. Not exactly. How about that? That looks pretty. Yeah. Okay. We can do it just like that. I don't want to. I can raise it back up. But I'll leave it like that so I can see it over the top and how is that operating. And same as before, grab our high poly and connect to our rigger. If you noticed, our grouping has decreased in size, meaning that the let's see if it works. Thought I saw some movement here at frame 0.5. Yeah, it works like that. We can try it this way. You select that and hit record again. If you notice, it looks as if the top one is a little slower. But you can go in here and go in here like this, and under configure, we can adjust the speed rotor parameters. Main rotor speed. We'll put up one up here. Okay, close that. We'll go back here, hit record again. See if that speeds it up a little bit. I think it's too fast. We'll stop that. Flip back. Go to configure and go to parameters 125. We'll do the same here on the rear, might as well. Okay, we'll do that right there. It's a little problem that our rear rotor is out of place totally. Well, it's on this side. Okay. Go here. I want to unlink it. Do this. Align it with this. And we'll do the re-recording here. See how that looks. Lazy bum. See how that looks. Okay, it's there. Do we have to do the recording again? Relink it. Close enough. You know, when you start working with this thing, you find yourself, I found myself being very confused about what's really going on with it. We're not finished linking this, by the way. But once you get into it and start messing around with the application, I found myself to be totally intrigued, engulfed in the application and its abilities. It's incredible. Stop that for a second. I'm going to unhide things and close our grouping. Because our grouping needs to be attached as well to our body. High poly to the low poly. Let's take it out for a ride. And we'll take a camera view from the follow view. We'll create something here. Okay. Plane. We'll do a plane real quick. Lay it down some. I tricked my camera. Okay, let's do this. Now we don't want to do Skype, idiot. Want to record or something. Let's do the movement. Go page up. Take a flight. Yeah, that's Skype. Come on, Skype. Works for me. So we're in flight now, you know, flight time. And like I said, this was rigged with a plugin, Craft Director Studio. And that's a pretty amazing plugin. I want to show you what else it does. We have the attack helicopter, right? And you want to basically not just fly, but about destroy some shit, right? You want to tear stuff up. We need an object here. We'll create another. Gotta create some more geometry. Let's do a box. A big box. Right? We'll redo the recording. Don't worry about that. And we need a tube. I want to change this. Change the colors so we can better see stuff. Right? And go back to frame zero. And wireframe. I want to be able to see something. This is a box. That'd be our target. With Rayfire, you can it has a shooting parameters. It has a shooting. Well, we need something to shoot with. I need a gun. Right, we need a gun. Let's create a gun. Standard. Do a tube. Have this tube come out of here, select our tube. We want to align our tube. Well, this parent link it to our vehicle, not the propellers. It'll move around and go crazy. We still have animation on our, yeah, we're in there. Want to do this alignment piece, get it in here, get it pointed in the right direction. Uh-huh. Out front here. Do a little rotation type deal. Rotate it. That'd be 90, right? Yeah, that'd be 90. Hey, 90. 90 degrees. So great. Some more alignment stuff here. Yep. We want to scale it. Close the radius on this. 2. See if it moves. Looking great. That's our gun. So 2. We want to change the geometry where you won't see it. We'll do that later. I want to make sure I hit what I said I want to hit. So I'm going to increase this. I need to be that thick. But we do need width. Yeah. I like that better. If we open our in our help, Rayfire help, we can open our that help. That's the bomb. Standard Rayfire shooting. Open our shooting floater. Declare our object box and our gun. And want to do our gun. Add holes and debris. Displacement well is automatic. Let's do a front view. And let's redo the animation. Redo the animation. So I think we're ready to rig this system. I mean, animate this thing here. I want to bring this down a little bit, ground level. With this plugin, Craft Director Studio, we can shoot some stuff. I'll take this angle and do the animation. Yep. So we want to go page up and then go that way. Don't want to get too close. Sounds great. A little short, sweet, simple animation. And stop it. Right, stop it. We got a nearly 2,000 frames in that sequence. And I wanted to make it right here in our parameters here, we got a start frame, end frame. Am I recording or why is it not taking off? Right, okay, we get a little height there. System don't crash. We can start at 900. It can penetrate the object. I'm making sure they're making contact. If the box and the tube can see each other. Well, the tube has to see the box. Boom. You know, do it just like that. I want to make sure everything's that our objects can see each other. We got 1200. We can start it. Start shooting. 1300 and roll off to 1500, 1600 right there. Our end frame will be 1589. Start frame will be 1200, and we can shoot this now. We will get dummy debris, we will get deformations in our impact object, the box, and it should work out pretty well. For the most part, we have the box in our tube. That's all we need for right now. Let's shoot this. Come back when that's done. No, we're staying here. As you can see, it's leaving holes. Yeah, it's memory intensive. It's doing a lot of calculations at this point. And I froze out. I can't do anything until the animation is complete. We'll have debris. For right now, when debris, it'll be dummy debris, so we have to specify what debris we want to give it. A series of geometric shapes that I'll show you how to create. And we wanted to interact with the floor, the plane. At this point, debris will fall through. We're going to get a lot of dummy debris. As soon as it's over, I'll show you. I see the holes in the box, our impact object. Can't see it from here. And we're going to 1589, 1600 frames. Still moving. I haven't crashed yet. Beautiful. Once we have this in place, you know, you can freeze it, hide it, redo it. Have it to, redo the total animation within our roll-up. Out here, we have a lot of stuff we can work with, just with the animation, yeah. We're at 1515, frame 1515. It'll be ready in a second. Yeah. Come on. Don't crash. That's what I'm hoping for. Don't crash. Excuse me. Sinus problems. Sinus season for me. You know, this is something different. Something to do other than pimping and selling dope, you know. Which I never done, you know, but we have that association attached to us. Little do people know. I'm on their ass. Animation's almost complete. 1585, four more frames. Uh-oh. 85, 89, we might get a warning stating that our tube missed this object. No, we didn't. We made it. We're successful. And as you can see here, we can roll it back, I think. Zoom in here if you allow me to zoom in. And we'll go to wireframe so you can see it. I shot a lot, so there we go. That's all dummy debris right there. And it's penetrating the floor. You won't see that in the final render. We have to assign debris to this debris. This is all dummy debris and stuff here. Show you how to do that when I get back.